Liqui Moly states that the ProLine throttle valve cleaner cleans the throttle valves and the intake area. Perhaps most interesting to me is the claim that it reliably cleans the intake valves even on GDI engines. And so today I'm going to be putting this product to the test, and I'll be attempting to clean these intake valves on my 2017 Accord, which has a GDI engine. I'll show before and after footage as usual, and I'll even be inspecting the catalytic converter before and after the procedure, since some of us have concerns that chemical cleaning could leave carbon chunks on the catalytic converter. Now let's get this. This is one product I'm excited about, just given the reputation that Liqui Moly has when it comes to fuel system cleaners and lubricants. First off is the before inspection of the catalytic converter, and so I take off the air fuel sensor. With the air fuel sensor out, I introduce my borescope, and here's what the catalytic converter looks like before the procedure. This footage will come in handy post-treatment. I should also put it out there that this video is not sponsored. All my fuel additive cleaning videos are not sponsored. Next, to inspect the intake valve, I remove the engine cover, follow up with the ignition coils and then the spark plugs, and introduce the borescope into cylinder 1. The intake valve is closed, and so I engage the crankshaft bolt through the wheel well, and turning it over, some dirty looking valves are exposed. These are quite carboned up, and just to state that even though each cylinder has two intake valves, I'll be sticking to a specific one for the before and after for ease of comparison. Going by the firing order, cylinder 3 is next to open. You can see multiple layers of carbon on the stem. At this point, I begin to wonder whether Liqui Moly can actually do something here. It definitely has its work cut out. Valves 2 and 4 also have significant deposits as well, and I'll leave the detailed comparison to post-treatment when I'll be showing the before and after side by side. I put everything back together and prepare to go on to cleaning. And although not stated, I decided to warm up the car through a quick drive, and with the car at operating temperature and off, the instruction is to create access to the butterfly plate of the throttle body beyond the MAF sensor. I loosen the hose clamp, detach the intake hose, and then insert the discharge pipe that comes with the product. Since the pipe is relatively thin and was being squashed initially, I decided to slide on this more rigid black hose over this particular area which was being squashed, and I wiggle the intake hose back in place. I start the car, and using the case of my torque wrench, I keep the RPM just above 2000 revolutions as recommended, and then I start spraying. Liqui Moly states that to clean the butterfly valve of the throttle body, you should move the hose back and forth. However, the throttle body isn't really my target. My focus remains on the intake valves and seeing if there will be any deposits on the catalytic converter. Some 10 plus minutes later and the can is empty. Then I leave it running above 2000 RPMs as recommended by Liqui Moly for at least 20 seconds. I ended up doing this for about a minute. There was no smoke coming from the exhaust except for when I revved it. The product doesn't say to drive the car afterwards, but I decided to do a spirited drive since I noticed that the car was missing a bit at idle. This is probably due to remnants of the product in the intake system. The check engine light didn't come on at any point, and in a few minutes of driving, the missing was gone. Drive done, and I returned for the moment of truth inspection. Taking a look at the after results, it became quite clear that I was going to do this another round. There was basically no difference between the before and after footage of the intake valves. I couldn't perceive any iota of cleaning, since the manufacturer stated that for dirty applications, a second treatment may be applied. I decided to pick up a second can and do it all over again. This time I had the engine at 2500 RPM just in case if that would help, and same as before, I completed this in about 10 minutes of spraying. Once I was done, I noticed that the check engine light and these other warning lights were on the dash, and the car was misfiring. For this Honda, all these lights simply tell you that the ECU is dazed and is reporting an engine problem. And after this, I went for a second spirited drive to clear off the product from the intake system. I took it easy initially until the missing cleared up, and then went ahead to put the pedal to the metal. I should also state that after about 3 drive cycles, all these lights turned off on their own. Now to the final results, and we move over to cylinder 1. Not much of a difference between the before and the after, but if we go microscopic, you can see that this part of the valve stem looks like it was cleaned up a bit. There's also a bit of an exposure of the intake port wall if you take a look at this area. However, in all, nothing dramatic. Moving over to cylinder 3, and again, no difference at all. In fact, if you take a look at the highlighted area in the after, it looks as though this part got some carbon deposited on it. Maybe some of the carbon from the intake manifold got deposited here. The story was the same for the valves in cylinders 2 and 4. Again, basically no difference between the before and the after. Moving over to the catalytic converter, it looks exactly the same way before the treatment, and I guess you would expect it to look that way since I didn't see any significant cleaning of the intake valves. In the end, I'll say this was largely unsuccessful. Some minor evidence of cleaning on the valves in cylinder 1, but every other thing looked the same. Let me know what you think in the comments. Maybe all roads lead to mechanical cleaning of these deposits. Like, share and subscribe if you love this kind of content, and I'll be sure to catch you on the next one. Peace!